I said I thought I was done with the two hype drama until MOPI and TD Presents gave us their story, but today this has gotten way worse than we could have possibly imagined. So it all started with Jesser going on YouTube and saying this.
All right, y'all, before we get into the video, I just want to talk to y'all because of everything that's been happening. Obviously, Tyler hasn't been around the last couple months, really, like uploading or on social media. He's been going through a lot mentally. Been fighting some serious demons. I'm not gonna go too in depth on that as his personal thing, but Tyler, I'm worried about you, dude. Like I said, I would take this whole thing offline. I reached out to your mom, expressing my worries. I talked to your brother for an hour, bro. He's really worried about you. Like you've been hiding things from him. Tyler, I want you, like I try calling you. Please just call me back. You don't respond to me or the guys. Like we want to help you. I'm not gonna go in depth. It's very personal, all of this stuff. Like Tyler, I literally saw you the other day after this happened. I told you I loved you, bro. You hugged me and then you don't respond to me. I haven't been able to sleep at night. Like I've tried to do is help this man. Obviously, I'm gonna try to keep everything offline. Like, I'm gonna try to talk to your family more because I'm worried about you, bro. I've known you forever. And all the people like hating on me, saying I snaked my best friend, like, you know nothing, bro. Y'all are fueling someone who's not okay. Imagine just like shitting on me when you know nothing about me and Tyler's relationship or what he's going through or what I'm going through. I just don't get it, man. Like, y'all have seen what I've done for my friends over the years. I got to the top and I brought so many people up with me, bro. That's what I'm about, dude. But I'm gonna continue making videos. I'm gonna continue making my thing. I'm not gonna make more videos about this, but Tyler, please reach out to me. And if you do make a video, I'll make a response video. Like, I talked to your brother. He doesn't want that. I don't want to do that. Please, Tyler, reach out. You don't have to do this, man. Enjoy the video, y'all.
I want you all to keep in mind that I'm not on either side because we truly don't know what happened right now. But I seen Jesser's video right as soon as it came out and I was like, wow, I really feel bad for Jesser because you can see he's put a lot of emotion into this and Mopi's obviously going through something. That's what's really happening is Mopi is going through some, you know, depression or something. So now I feel really bad about both sides because they're obviously going through something that's extremely bad and it's, you know, hurt their friendship. But in Jesser's video at the end where he was talking about that, he said, I'm not gonna make any more videos about this, but if he makes a response, I'm gonna make one. He kind of chuckled, which I don't know how I feel about that, but just look back at this and understand what he said.
I'm not gonna make more videos about this, but Tyler, please reach out to me. And if you do make a video, I'll make a response video. Like I talked to your brother, he doesn't want that. I don't wanna do that.
He literally said, I'm not going to make another video on it, but if you make a response, I'm going to. And then he chuckled, like, I don't know. That's what right off the bat confused me. But then Mopi went on to Twitter that night, a few hours later, and this is insane. This is what just blew it way out of proportion that we had no idea this would go to, and it's officially happened. Like, he was served a cease and desist. They're trying to silence me. I won't allow it. Using a cease and desist and trying to paint me as mentally unstable shows the lengths these guys will go to hide their actions. They're not victims. Don't fall for it. And we'll read that in just a second, but I didn't even know what a cease and desist was. I just knew it was bad. But then this guy posted on Twitter to clarify for everyone that was wondering, and it's crazy, okay? It is actually insane. You know, I'm not in law school or anything, or I don't really know the law, but after this, I looked at it a lot differently, okay? He said, to clarify, a cease and desist notice is not a demand, but rather a notice, despite what it states here. Normally, a cease and desist is just the advice of someone's attorney to not go forward with anything that might be considered slanderous. This is more of a threat, not okay. So slandering itself is something that you can sue for, apparently, and it's like talking trash about someone's company or their brand, or usually it means that they're saying something about their brand that's not true to make their brand like lose money and stuff. So that's kind of what 2hype is going with. They're actually going to sue him or try to sue him if he comes out with something that is slanderous towards 2hype. So basically what they're doing is they're trying to censor Mopi from dropping this response video that he's been talking about. Now, will he still drop this video after that? We have no idea. He has not gave us an update. TD Presents hasn't said anything on the situation. And now it's gotten way bigger than it could ever have possibly gotten. Like, we're literally in terms of court of the law right now if anything continues at all. So maybe we will actually never know what happened now because of this. And that's crazy that Jester said, hey, you know, I'm not going to make any more videos about this, but I'll make a response if you do. And he chuckled about it. So, like, I really don't know what happened now. But I want you guys to know this is not any normal beef or just some regular beef that's happening on the internet. This tweet has been out for 15 hours and has 28,000 likes, 2,600 retweets. Something that's viral has around, you know, you could say something's viral with like 10,000, 20,000 likes. This is literally a viral tweet and this is going all across the internet. So let's read exactly what it says just in case you guys wanted to hear that, and then we'll get into some more stuff. But this is crazy right here. This is something you need to see. It says, dear, I guess Mopi, it has come to the attention of my client to Hype, the company, that your client Tyler Glenn is engaged in derogatory and misleading communications publicly about the company and its representatives. Such communications have appeared among other places on social media platforms that are frequent by followers and fans of the company and the Too Hype Creative Collective. My client has also learned that Mr. Glenn intends to release a video disparaging the company and or its representatives. False or misleading statements or communications that disparage the company and or its representatives constitute defamation, trade libel, or other actionable torts for which Mr. Glenn may be liable for compensatory and punitive damages. The company demands that Mr. Glenn immediately cease and desist from any and all such conduct and other actions that have the effect of disparaging the company or its principals. The company will seek legal resource to hold Mr. Glenn liable for any damage he causes as a result. It has been the intention of the company to settle amicably its affairs with Mr. Glenn once he decided to leave the Too Hype group, but his recent actions and failure to address the situation despite the company's attempt to do so has made that difficult. We strongly suggest that he take a different approach and are still open to discussing how the situation can be resolved in a mutually agreeable manner. So, as it says, it has been the intention of the company to settle amicably its affairs. They didn't mention that Mopi signed some sort of non-disclosure agreement. I'm not into like law or anything, like I said, guys, but it seems like that Mopi was not in the intention of doing that. Maybe they tried to sign something with him so that he wouldn't say anything. And from their words, it seems like that's not what happened. He did not agree to that, but we never know. I'm not in law school, you know, I don't know about law, but that's crazy. As you guys can see, they literally are going to sue him, and it said that it could be about money. They could try and take money from him and a whole bunch of stuff. You know, I don't really know about all, you know, this law stuff, but I can read the words and what it says. Compensation is money. So it's like, what is really happening? Like, now we have to see, like, what actually, it had to be something insane. You guys see what I'm talking about? Had to be something crazy that happened that forced all this. I don't know if we'll ever know after today, but Troy Dan tweeted out some eye emojis as soon as that came out, so he's definitely seeing it. This was very interesting. The former editor of Too Hype said, yikes, man, I'm not trying to get involved in this, but when I was the editor for Too Hype, you were the only one who treated me like a fellow human being. For that, I thank you. I hope all is well, Mopi, and I'll always support and respect you as a person and a creator. So, man, I mean, it's just like, it gets worse and worse for Too Hype as the situation keeps unfolding, but I don't know what side to be on. But like, I mean, if you look at it from the way of everyone who leaves has an issue with them, it's kind of hard to be on their side, even though we don't know the story yet. You see what I'm saying, guys? So, man, even the editor came out and said that they weren't treating him like a normal person. So I really don't know. I mean, it's crazy. You guys seen TD retweeted that. He also retweeted this of Mopi trying to, you know, of that tweet we just seen. Los went on to Twitter. He quote tweeted that tweet and he was like, SMH, are you kidding me? So he's not happy with that. You guys know he said that Too Hype was liars and manipulators and all that. So it's getting crazy, man. It's really getting crazy out here. The Flight Mike came out onto Twitter and said, never do business with your friends, man, ... It almost always ends ugly. Los was, I guess he was going through LSK's videos, comments, And he picked apart a few, saying my favorite comments so far. And it was just like comments that didn't really seem like they had a lot of IQ towards them. You know what I'm saying? So he was basically making fun of the people that are defending too hype. Once again, I really don't know what side I'm on, but I'm leaning more towards the people that aren't in too hype, because something is happening, man. Like, something's got to be happening to where everyone that leaves has something bad to say about them. I don't know. But this guy said, you STFU, you're delusional. Look at their point of view. Okay, you're acting like they're very bad people. Chris showed you poof. He said their point of what? Question mark, question mark, question mark. So he's, you know, he's trying to say that these people that are defending them are dumb, pretty much. Like, they have a very low IQ, you know what I'm saying? So I really don't know what to say, guys, once again, because I don't know. We don't know what's happening. I can't really make a decision because we haven't heard a lot. We haven't heard both sides. We haven't heard why this all happened, but LSK, you know, he was not one to talk about the MOPI situation at all in his video. He even said it in the beginning of the video that he's not even going to discuss it. In Cash Nasty's video, he said not all people are perfect, people make mistakes. So it's like, I really think something happened between MOPI and Jesser, and it's just not able to be solved on MOPI's side. Maybe, I mean, it kind of seems like Jesser is trying, has tried to fix it, but MOPI is not wanting to do that. And you know, whatever happened, maybe it's justice, you know what I'm saying? Maybe there's no reason for him to. Maybe it went too far. We don't know. We don't know yet. We don't know if this video is ever going to drop now. We don't know if we're ever going to hear another side of this story, but this could be the end of the drama, guys, because of the cease and desist. We'll see. Drop a like on the video. Let me know your opinions down below. Hit that subscribe button if you're new. It's your boy Badger Plug. You've been plugged in, and I'm out.